Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Bow and Arrow Tarot. Today we're going to get right into the weekly reading for the sign of Aquarius. Let's get out your romance angel messages straight out. I'm going to pull out three of these, get right into it, Aquarius, and then we're going to pull out your animal spirits and go from there, all right? So let's just see what the romance angels have to say about your week and your deeper relationships. Straight out, we have soulmate. Nice. We have love yourself first, of course. And we have let go of control issues. All right. Some of those cards are regular players for you guys, Aquarius, right? So let's go ahead, pull out your animal spirits and see what they have for you this week. And then we can go on into your traditional spread. Animal spirits can be representative of energies coming available to you, individuals you're dealing with, or stages in your life that you may be about to enter into or maybe coming out of as well, right? So let's just see what it all entails for you this week, my lovely Aquarius. Cheetah, beautiful fire energy. The buffalo, beautiful earth energy, a mix between the earthly and the heavenly. And we have horse energy, wow. Three powerhouse animal spirits for you this week, Aquarius. Very, very nice indeed. Let's get right into it. The cheetah, very strong masculine energy associated with solar force. The cheetah is single-minded. Powerful, determined, focused, purposeful. The cheetah absolutely radiates the energy of the sun out of its heart, in a sense, right? Fire, strong fire. The cheetah is an absolutely awe-inspiring animal spirit to encounter, and anyone resonating with this energy is really someone where you can actually feel the energy coming off of them. This is someone who goes after their sort of goals and objectives single-mindedly, and they have a way of really achieving huge sort of feats of manifestation, right? It's just whenever you see somebody resonates with cheetah energy, it's just like it's really amazing to see how they're able to accomplish the things that they accomplish. They have such swiftness, such power. They're able to adjust their course anywhere they need to adjust it to get what they to get their desired goal, right? Very strong. And so certainly when we're talking about achievement, this is one of the strongest cards in the deck. Now, buffalo energy is of course an earth animal spirit, but the buffalo is extremely strong, extremely grounded and practical, yet highly spiritual. This is really the bridge between the earth and the heavens. And so the buffalo really does not shy away from trials and tribulations or difficult times, illness, fear of death, difficult paths in life. None of this worries the buffalo, because the buffalo sees every single opportunity or every single sort of, I'm going to say difficulty in life, as an opportunity to transcend. Very strong, very wise animal, of course. And of course, it's one of these animals that is associated with wisdom, ancient wisdom, right? Very, very strong. Now, the horse is also an incredibly strong earth animal spirit, and the horse is really the master of self transformation, self mastery. The horse is able to sort of harness the power of fire and earth. In a lot of ways, right? Even though it is an earth creature, the intuitional level of the horse is really without bounds. The horse is one of the strongest animals for sort of stability, right? Maintaining stability and maintaining its endurance. It can keep going and going and going. It carries us over very, very difficult terrain. And the horse, you know, is really, you know, the only other animal that is that matches the horse maybe is the lion in terms of self transformation, right? Self-mastery, right? The horse is a very strong earth animal. And so we're talking about stability, huge amounts of stability. We're talking about being able to manifest incredible feats here and goals. And of course, being able to bridge earth and the heavens in the most divine way here with the buffalo. These are really three powerhouses, I'm going to be honest with you. All right, Aquarius, let's get right into it. Gonna pull out your spreads for the week. Really incredible. I've never really usually these animal spirits, you know, you may find one or two of them in one reading, but to have all three of these in the same reading is really quite incredible. All right. Straight out we have Two of Wands. I don't read reversals. Star energy. And we have Nine of Cups. All right. You guys are coming into this week with Two of Wands energy, right? So you are raring to go. Two of Wands is Mars and Aries energy. And Mars in Aries is all about sort of taking the next step. Now the seed has been planted for your vision, right? The opportunity, the ace, right, has come, the Ace of Wands. And now you're absolutely all about sort of taking the next steps towards achieving your goal. And so this is how you're going this week. This is very, very strong, you know. This is, of course, resonating with these animal spirits, right? We're talking about going out into the world. Of course, the world is his oyster right now, but he has a particular vision. You have a particular vision, Aquarius. And so this week, it's all about taking the next steps to realizing that. You come into the week and you're matched with star energy, right? And star energy is all about sort of tending to your wish, your ultimate wish for your life, right? Your ultimate goal for your life, right? But tending to it, the star talks about always sort of pouring your heart into the practical sides, pouring your emotions into the practicality of manifesting your dreams, right? And your dreams and your wishes, always tending to that manifestation, right? And ensuring that you are focused and at one with what you're trying to achieve, right? And so this week, you're doing that, right? You're absolutely doing that. And of course, I'm going to say star energy is also really about sort of taking opportunities and reevaluating different stages along this path to achieving your wish and making sure that you're always keeping in line with your ultimate aim and not being sort of veered off the path, right? And so events are going to come in this week that may challenge that a little bit, just to make sure you know exactly which way you're going. Where are you going with this, right? And you round the week off with a Nine of Cups, which is a feeling of blessings, and sort of happiness, right? You realize how lucky you are in some area of your life. And I'm going to say that Nine of Cups is oftentimes, you know, with all the nine cards, in fact, we have a sense of being walking that path alone, right? And with the Nine of Cups, yes, you are very happy, you are very blessed, but it does seem to be that one cup of love, that last cup of love that sort of takes you up to completion, still has not quite arrived. Yes, you have happy relationships, you have happy family ties, you've been blessed in a lot of ways, but yet that one cup of love is quite elusive. And I think that perhaps part of this energy is that by the end of the week, maybe you may begin to be thinking about that. It's interesting that star will come in, because star is kind of a constant reevaluation to make sure that you, your actions and your life path is in line with your ultimate goal, right? And so it could be that this reevaluation is really taken, not so much reevaluation, but the tending to it and the constant sort of, I'm going to say, fine-tuning. You know, it's a constant fine-tuning, right? This week, at some point, while you're going through the events and you're doing this fine-tuning of your path, that you may begin to say, maybe there's room for this deeper love in my path too. Because right now the Two of Wands is very much about sort of your ambition for yourself, right? Your passion for your life and how you want to lead your life. And so it could very well be that, yes, you are happy and blessed, but you're making room now or considering making room for that special sort of connection. Justice, Ten of Cups. And the Ace of Wands, and there's your ace, right? So this week for some of you, justice comes in a way to sort of rebalance something in your life, right? And so you're resonating with this energy this week. Of course, justice is associated with the sign of Libra, which is your sister sign, Aquarius. And you're resonating sort of with this feeling of wanting to rebalance something in your life, right? You come up against this Ten of Cups energy. Justice can sometimes indicate also an official rendering or decision that comes in, an official or business judgment that comes in that serves to sort of deserves to rebalance a situation, or that brings justice to a situation where there was perhaps an injustice, an imbalance, right? And so, yes, you're the one who's coming in with this energy. And so you're very keenly focused on that. You're very keenly focused on sort of bringing balance back into your life. Perhaps you've been spending too much time on your career and not enough on the family, or too much time in love and not enough on your career. Whatever the case may be, somewhere along the line this week, you're wanting to rebalance your life a little bit. And of course, you're met with Ten of Cups. And I'm going to say this Ten of Cups is very much a completion that comes in. It could very well be that a judgment does come in for you this week. You've been waiting, maybe holding on for this judgment, because it is allowing a completion in a love connection. You may have been holding off from taking the next steps to reaching a Ten of Cups because you were waiting for this decision to come in. That can be another reason why you've been resonating with justice so much. It's been so much on your mind, and you've been concentrating on, you know, getting that part of your life done. And now that it comes in for you this week, it feels like it opens up the way for you to really solidify a love connection, right? This is the 10 that I was talking about earlier with the 9, right? So now you have a solidified, deep, and long-lasting union, and there's completion. You're ready to start your life together. Also, this can indicate sometimes, for instance, if you've been seeing somebody, you've been in a relationship, if you've been waiting for the finalization of a divorce, right, or finalization of some kind of judgment, like I said, it can now make the way for you to perhaps go to the next level, perhaps get engaged, move in together, take this relationship to the next level of commitment, right? Now that whatever obstacle was in the way for this completion has now been cleared with this Justice card, and you round the week off with an Ace of Wands. And it feels very much like you are, you know, you've completed this higher level of commitment, this decision to move forward together now and have your life together. It's like the new, right? It's the beginning. It's the completion and the beginning, right? And all of a sudden you have an Ace of Wands, and that really seems to indicate a whole new life of creative energy coming in. You know, you feel like, oh, I can do the things I've been wanting to do. And it seems to be a huge opportunity now for you to be as creative as you've always wanted to be. Now that you have your family, your union solidified, you have this judgment behind you, and it really feels like the beginning of a very passionate sort of stage in your life. Five of Wands, Eight of Wands, and Nine of Pentacles. So some of you are coming in this week and there's been a lot of power struggle, right? A lot of arguing and bickering. And five, of course, is the number for power struggle. Five of Wands, we find a competitiveness, right? Everyone's trying to win, trying to be on top. And you're really embroiled in this sort of dynamic, right? And so you come into the week with this sort of energy. It's not pleasant, right? It's exhausting, and you are met with an Eight of Wands, and it's almost as if in the middle of all of this arguing, you have all of this other sort of information coming in. Now, I feel strongly that this is very much, sometimes Eight of Wands is very much the viral card, like, you know, you're going viral. And I feel like, for instance, up until now, you may have been struggling and arguing, and there's been a lot of competitiveness. It may not have been, of course, from you may not have been the one to start this, but there are people around you competing, so you're naturally pulled into this dynamic. But this week you go viral. Something happens, all of a sudden information starts coming in. It can be quite chaotic. And so Eight of Wands, it can be interpreted in a multitude of ways depending on the situation. But I think in this situation here, we're talking about a ramping up of your fame. You know what I mean? A ramping up of energy coming in to do with something that you're very passionate about. I feel like this is definitely perhaps for someone who is an artist in some way, or someone who where fame or notoriety or attention is part of their career. And this week it ramps right up. The, you know, everything starts to come in. The phone starts to ring, the emails start to come in. You round the week off with a Knight of Pentacles. Why? Because you have just your abundance and your next stage, right, has just resonated higher in terms of your career and your passion. And you absolutely take yourself out of this Five of Wands. A Nine of Pentacles person does not bother to entertain a Five of Wands situation because rewards are coming in. You don't have to compete with anybody. You've proven to be the master. You've proven to be successful. You are now in the garden of your own making. And I think that by the end of the week, you absolutely get lifted out of this sort of mediocre level almost, right? Maybe not even mediocre. I'm just going to say average level, you know, of engagement, you know, people who've been competing with you. But because all of a sudden the attention is ramped up, the, you know, the all of the information coming in, the messages coming in, it's all like, you know, just ramping up this week. And of course, along with it comes abundance, right? And comes rewards. By the end of the week, you are absolutely in a beautiful garden. You are absolutely sort of established, right? You've sort of risen above the rest of everyone else, and you are the one that kind of moves forward. Really nice indeed. Four of Wands, Queen of Cups, and the Page of Pentacles. This is your last read, Aquarius. Some of you are coming into this week with a new relationship. Four of Wands is Venus and Aries energy, and it is, of course, the 11-11 card, but Four of Wands is really the soulmate or twin flame journey, because four is the number for stability and Wands is all about passion, right? And so also with this Venus in Aries energy, it's the start of something new in beauty and love, but it starts with such a strong, stable base that it has all of the right components, all of the right ingredients for a true twin flame sort of journey. You're met with the Queen of Cups, and so there's someone in your life, excuse me, who is absolutely wanting to offer you your a cup of love. I want to say this is your going to be sort of your divine feminine soulmate coming in, which is part of this connection, right? But the Queen of Cups is very much sort of the supporter, the nurturer, the one who's really feeding the emotions of the relationship. It's really encouraging you to exchange your cup of love with each other and to share your feelings with each other. She is extremely emotional. She is extremely sensitive. And I'm going to say for some of you, this may indeed be the person that you have this new sort of soulmate connection with. But by the end of the week, Page of Pentacles comes in. Page of Pentacles is very, very practical. And this feels very much like sort of, because the Queen of Cups is being so open and really sharing her desires and emotions with you, by the end of the week, you know, it's almost as if you guys have met, gotten together, you're in love, and you're right away being very practical about the next steps. What do we do next? Are we going to move in? You know, what's the next sort of practical steps on a day-to-day level about with this union? Because Page of Pentacles is all about sort of bringing whatever you need to do down to the ground, you know. Sorry about that. I got a helicopter in the background all of a sudden. Page of Pentacles is very much about, you know, crossing the T's, dotting the I's, coming up with day-to-day solutions to any problems that may come up, all in the effort of moving towards manifesting something in the here and now, manifesting something right down on the ground. And so this feels very much like the beginning stages of bringing what is a very spiritual and emotional love connection right down to the ground, to the practical, to the realistic of, okay, now how do we move forward, right? And you sit down and really have, you know, this discussion, you know, okay, well, what do we do now? Do you want to move in with me? Should I move in with you? You know, and it's a happy feeling. It doesn't feel like a burden or anything. It's a very, very happy feeling. It's certainly something that would be the natural next step in a love connection. It just seems to be happening very quickly here for some of you, and certainly on the heels of a fairly fresh love connection. All right, guys, this is your reading, January 5th to the 11th for Aquarius. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share. Leave me a comment if you like. Don't forget to hit the bell so you're notified of my premieres. But for right now, Aquarius, have a wonderful week. And I'll see you next week for the weeklies. Bye-bye now.